Have you ever dreamt about going to a place where no one has been to before? No, no, no. I'm not referring to planet Mars, since that's what Elon Musk and NASA are tasked to figure out. Why don't we travel far, further than Mars instead? Today, would you mind going to the gas giant Jupiter through a rocket? What are you waiting for? Pack your belongings and prepare, because the rocket will launch in a few minutes. Sit back, buckle up, and relax. The rocket is launching in 3, 2, 1. As we are launching, be reminded that going to the solar system's most intriguing planet will take more than 5 years. But don't be stopped by that, because this journey is going to be worthwhile. Jupiter is known to be the largest planet in the solar system, and landing and having a walk on its surface isn't possible. The gases nitrogen and helium make up the majority of its atmosphere. You might imagine that landing on Jupiter is similar to landing on a cloud, and due to the fact that it's mostly composed of gas, we should be able to fly right through Jupiter's atmosphere and out the other end, right? Sorry to burst your bubble, but things aren't that simple in this gas giant. Now get ready, because we're nearing Jupiter. I'd like you to keep looking out the window until we've successfully entered its atmosphere. Do you have any idea how large this planet is? While the massive planet in front of you has a radius large enough to hold 5.5 Earth-sized planets. Moreover, it's hollow inside. It can hold another 1,300 planets. I can sense that as your knowledge of Jupiter grows, so does your desire to explore it. So let's keep going. Take a look at the white ovals that cover the surface. Are you curious as to what they are? We can call these Jupiter's jewels. The southern hemisphere of Jupiter is surrounded by 7 gigantic whirlwinds of beautiful white color, which look like a chain of pearls. Can you see the famous Great Red Spot? Its diameter is around 1.3 times larger than that of Earth. The Great Red Spot can be considered a massive anticyclonic storm and the solar system's greatest atmospheric whirlwind. In just a few minutes, we'll be diving into the depths of this giant planet. As we enter Jupiter's upper atmosphere, I want you to hold on tightly to your seats. You may notice that the rocket is swaying dramatically at this point. Well, this is because we are traveling at a speed of almost 177 kilometers per hour, or about 110,000 miles per hour. But don't worry, the spaceship's thick walls are responsible for keeping you safe from the turmoil outside. However, keep in mind that we haven't even gotten close to Jupiter's real atmosphere. But can you feel that? It's already extremely hot. It's not surprising given that the temperature at this point is 727 degrees Celsius or 1340 degrees Fahrenheit. Are you starting to feel scared? Because Jupiter revolves around its axis so quickly, like a spinning top, one day on this planet lasts only 10 Earth hours. Additionally, the rate at which wind blows here is around 500 kilometers per hour, or more than 300 miles per hour. The strongest hurricanes on Earth travel at 250 kilometers per hour, or about 155 miles per hour. Yet that rate is doubled when talking about hurricanes on Jupiter. But wait, did you notice something? It's a bit odd that as we travel deeper into the surface, the temperature appears to be going down. At this time, the temperature outside the rocket has reduced to negative 73 degrees Celsius, or negative 100 degrees Fahrenheit. On the contrary, the pressure has grown. As we leave Jupiter's stratosphere, we'll fly straight into its troposphere. As we move deeper, you'll notice that the temperature, pressure, and wind speed seem to increase. But try to put that aside for a moment and enjoy the view. Take a close look at those dense ammonia clouds swirling around us. Isn't it beautiful? Have you seen those flashes? Well, that's Jupiter's lightning. It's worth noting that those flashes are really powerful. It can actually spread throughout Jupiter's atmosphere and can be as large as the United States of America. And with that, dear passenger, I'd like you to know that we've traveled 2% towards the center of Jupiter, and I know there's obviously a lot more. Unfortunately, this is where all of our previous researchers have reached. did you know that the spacecraft Galileo disconnected with Earth at 1,162 kilometers, or 722 miles, or 133 kilometers, or 83 miles below visible clouds? It was then destroyed by the planet's extreme pressures, and it was only able to stand for about 58 minutes in Jupiter's deadly atmosphere. Despite that, it was a remarkable achievement for mankind, a big step into new information. It's been more than a decade since then, and I believe that technology has changed and progressed over time, enough for our current spacecraft to stand a much longer battle into this giant gas planet. We have traveled 4,000 kilometers, or approximately 2,500 miles, so it isn't really the time to go back. We have no choice but to move even closer to Jupiter's center, which is also one of space's greatest unsolved mysteries. Jupiter's core is not just hot, but it's really, really, really hot. The temperature outside our rocket has grown to 3,371 degrees Celsius, which is equal to 6,100 degrees Fahrenheit. But don't be scared, our rocket is built of super strong metal. That is extremely durable. On the other hand, if the rocket's material is weak, our journey exploring this planet would already stop here. We can barely see anything now, so we could only navigate into this enormous stream instinctively. Because all of the radio signals have been absorbed by the giant planet's environment, and most especially at this depth, we can't connect with anyone and anything outside this planet. We can only continue to dive towards Jupiter's depths, the only area on this planet where no human has ever set foot and where no space probe has ever gone. Take a look at that. It's a tremendous boiling ocean of some unknown material. Keep in mind that we are on Jupiter's interior layers at a depth of more than 20,000 kilometers, or roughly 12,500 miles. Even the world's finest scientists would have a hard time explaining what actually happens here. Even though we haven't actually reached Jupiter's core, we can already feel the heat. It's even hotter than the sun's surface. Moreover, its pressure is 2 million times that of the Earth's surface. Because of these extreme conditions, the hydrogen in Jupiter's atmosphere undergoes such drastic changes. The atoms in hydrogen molecules become so close together that their electrons become bonded, similar to that of metal. Thus, a new state of hydrogen called metallic hydrogen is formed. Could you believe that the universe's lightest element is being squeezed and heated to the point that it adopts the qualities of metal? It's pretty unimaginable. Unfortunately, we don't have a way to take a closer look at this ocean. Why? It's because metallic hydrogen has the ability to reflect lights very effectively. That means no matter how intensely we turn the brightest spotlights, we won't be able to see anything below. 90% of the light will just be reflected. Oh, could you feel that? Our spacecraft looks to have become stuck in some type of swamp, and it's making us stationary. It could be due to the tension between the planet's gravitational forces and the buoyancy of hydrogen. It's as though we're simultaneously descending into the core and being pushed upward to the surface. However, there is a debate on whether it truly is a swamp, especially since scientists have compared its density to that of a rock. Now, what would happen to the rocket? It would continue to violently shake for a little more until coming to a complete stop in Jupiter's center and becoming a free-floating body. In this situation, we appear to be in a serious problem. I think that it's best to teleport back to Earth right away before we run out of time to save ourselves. You could be wondering if there's something more interesting beneath the surface. Of course, there's Jupiter's core. However, no one knows what this massive planet's core contains because it has yet to be discovered. Some experts believe the core is a molten liquid ball. Others think it's a rocky object with a mass of 14 to 18 times that of Earth. A layer of metallic hydrogen may surround the dense center core, with a layer of molecular hydrogen on top. But one thing is, in fact, certain. It's going to be really hot. It can reach temperatures of up to 35,000 degrees Celsius. Even the core, according to reports, could not endure that extreme heat. And it may melt. It's sad that we can't fly deeper and see everything for ourselves. We could have settled the debate, if only we could. But whatever the case may be, let's leave this mystery to still be a mystery. So, is it possible for a rocket to reach Jupiter's core? Well, it is evident that traveling to the center of Jupiter on a rocket is absolutely impossible. In fact, the rocket would collide with the ocean of metallic hydrogen before we even reach the center. That kind of a journey would be very unhappy. Nonetheless, we discovered some fascinating information about Jupiter. First, there is a tremendous amount of pressure and overwhelming radiation. Second, Jupiter had the solar system's greatest magnetic field, as well as unusually extreme temperatures. Of course, we have to mention its strong hurricanes and huge whirlwinds. Lastly, Jupiter has a mixture that destroys and absorbs everything near it. At this point, we have to put our attention away from this massive boiling hydrogen cauldron and towards something else, like the space probes. Have you heard about the spacecraft Juno? Since 2016, this spacecraft Juno has been exploring Jupiter's atmosphere and gathering new information and discoveries. When the spacecraft entered the magnetosphere of Jupiter, it heard the roar of Jupiter. And the roar sounds like this. You can also see the most beautiful and powerful auroras in our entire solar system. And it's all millions of kilometers away from Earth. However, despite these many discoveries, Jupiter remains a difficult planet to explore, with more questions remaining unanswered and just continuing to pile up. What are your opinions if there would be another spacecraft going into this mission? Do you think it would be able to penetrate Jupiter's core and unveil its secrets? Tell us what you think in the comments section. If you're interested in exploring the unknown, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next videos.